Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're doing a team building guide on the Confronting Despair Super Saiyan Gohan Future and the LR Trunks Another Ending Super Saiyan Trunks Future. Both of these guys are future category leaders, so we're pretty much going to be doing the same exact teams with these guys, but we're just going to be talking about best linking buddies and teams that you can run with each of them. Pretty much the team building guides when it comes down to the Future Saga are going to be very, very similar, but let's just go over and see what we have here. So first off, the Future Gohan. His leader ability, When Dokken Awakened, is Future Saga category, Ki plus 3, HP plus 130%, Attack and Defense plus 170%. So the future guys actually get a really ridiculous buff attack and defense, which means that they're going to be doing a lot of damage and be taking almost nothing. It's actually a very, very amazing good stat. Super attack raises attack and defense one turn and causes immense damage to the enemy. So preferably you would want to keep him in the second slot so that way he can get a super attack off to increase his defense. His passive skill is Hope for the Future. Attack plus 100%, raises defense by 100%. The less health remaining, the greater the boost. So that's pretty crazy. And increases damage reduction by 10% at the start of each turn up to 50%. So after 5 turns, you have a 50% damage reduction and you increase your defense the lower your HP goes. And that's just insane. He's going to be taking almost no damage. And just having 100% passive skill with immense damage is awesome. Link skills are Golden Warrior, All in the Family, Super Saiyan, Experienced Fighters, Dismal Future, Prepared for Battle, and Fierce Battle. So he actually has a really good Link skill set. I think All in the Family is the only one that's kind of like, eh. Everything else, Super Saiyan, Experienced Fighters has a good amount of cards in it. Dismal Future is going to be pretty much seen on this team just because it's a future category team. Prepared for Battle and Fierce Battle. Plus, not to mention, he can be run pretty well on a monophysical team. Categories are Hybrid Saiyans and Future Saga. And max stats are HP of 12,580, attack of 9,636, and defense of 6,540. You can go ahead and do the base dupe system and unlock spans if you want to read through that. Just go ahead and pause the video or check out the wiki, by the way. Shout out to the wiki and shout out to DokkanBattleBuilder.com for all this information and helpful, useful stuff that I'm using. Anyway, 12 key multipliers, 150%, and the raise attack and defense for one turn is a 30% buff to the super attack multiplier and defense. So there you go, that's his card. In terms of best linking buddies, let's go over here. Actually, let me switch over to my Dokkan Battle Builder view. Here we go, we have Gohan over here. He links very, very well with a lot of units in-game, as you can see on the screen. The LR, Goku, and Vegeta Angel are here that he links very well with them. 5 link slots total. Golden Warrior, Super Saiyan, Experienced Fighters, Prepared for Battle, and Fierce Battle. So that's actually a phenomenal amount. That's 35% attack buff and 3 key. You have the other Trunks who is available, the OG hero leader, key plus 1 HP, attack and defense plus 70%. He has what? Golden Warrior, Super Saiyan, Dismal Future, Prepared for Battle, and Fierce Battle. That's not bad. 25% attack buff and a lot of key. And pretty much all of the Trunks is over here. You have a lot of good link skills, Golden Warrior, Super Saiyan. So it's pretty much all going to be about the same with the Trunks. It's going to be about 3 or 4 key and 25% attack buffs. Attack buffs all across the board. And that's actually exactly what it is. He also links for 5 links with Gogeta, which is pretty awesome. He does have Experienced Fighter. So he has 35% attack buff and 3 key. So actually, that's probably going to be one of his better linking buddies as well. And then you have the TUR variant of the LR Goku and Vegeta, which probably just be kept up over here, just so that way you see it. But yeah, he actually links very, very well. So you could see that he will do good on a Heroes team. I mean, honestly, on a Heroes team, you already have physical, intelligence, strength, technique, all you need really is agility at that point, and you can make a full team. And unfortunately, there's nothing 5 or more with him specifically, but you have a huge selection. And honestly, for a Heroes team, you have over here your Gogeta, which is an awesome card to choose. You can't really have 2 physicals if you're running a Vegito blue team, because you need to have at least this is exactly what you want to do. This is not going to be good on a Heroes team. But anyway, Intelligence Gogeta would be awesome to run on that team. In terms of next linking buddies, this is going to be a physical team. On a mono physical team, 4 or more, we already talked about the LR and the TUR variant of the Goku and Vegeta. You also have this Goku over here, which is the attack defense down for intelligence units. Attack defense, attack down for intelligence units. That is what he is here for. Actually, let me increase that a little bit for y'all, because that way you can see it a little bit better. You have the Vegito, Super Vegito, actually, the physical Super Vegito links for four or more. You have the buff Trunks, the support Trunks, and the Gotenks unit over here. They are all actually really good units, except for maybe the buff Trunks. He's kind of whack. But outside of him, everyone else here is actually pretty decent. Actually, this Goku is actually pretty awesome, too. If you're running him as a leader for, like, Super Battle Road, there's going to be almost no damage taken when you run a double Goku lead. But overall, let's see. With the Goku, he links with... the Sun family, experienced fighters, prepared for battle and fierce battle, so maybe not so much there. He does get a nice defensive buff, and he already tanks a lot that Gohan, so that's just going to increase his ability to tank. I personally would never run this Goku on a team. He's just kind of there for collective purposes. Vegito, Super Vegito here for four links, for four links, and you have, what, Golden Warrior, so three key and 25% attack buffs. Buff Trunks, if you don't have anyone else to run, you have 25% and 3 key. The support unit Trunks, if you're going to run him, it's going to be 4 key. Wow, 4 key and 10% attack buff. So having this Trunks just on a physical team, obviously he's not going to be a primary rotation. You can put him there and have Gohan in the middle, which you're going to want to run him in the middle anyway. He's going to get an additional 4 key, so he's almost always going to get super attacks off. Then you also have Gotenks if you happen to want to run him on a mono physical team, which he's also another staple. That's 25% and 3 key. 25% attack buff and 3 key. So that's pretty damn awesome. Next one is going to be Hybrid Saiyans, four or more. There's just so much here. We've talked about a lot of the stuff already. Pretty much any Super Saiyan hybrid, so it's just almost everything. Over here, he links very, very well with. I'm not going to go over every single one of them. We've already talked about most of these, and a lot of the other ones, it's just that, you know, it's the same exact link skills. So pretty much here, he's going to be linking with at least 10% attack buff and up to like 4 key total with everyone. So you can go pick and choose who you want on your Hybrid Saiyan team. My picks for best ones to run would probably be this Trunks over here. Let's get these guys down here. So this Trunks, this Gotenks most likely, the old G hero leader, support unit, this Trunks over, or this Gotenks over there. And the TUR variant of the LR Gohan. Yeah, that's probably about it. So those are, and maybe this OG Gohan as well. He does do some decent damage since he has immense damage multiplier. But that's about it. But I probably wouldn't even have him on that team. Just because there's other better units that you could run. But this would be the primary ones that you could run. For five or more, it's going to be one of the two Trunkses over here. So just pick and choose which one you run and take a look at your opponent. If you're going up against an agility opponent or an opponent with mostly agility stages or a final stage that's agility, probably bring the Tech Trunks. And if it's going to be a technique stage, probably bring over the Intelligence Trunks. Obviously, play towards the weakness of the enemy or the enemy's weakness. Everyone else here can link with him for decent link skills, but you have other choices. Next one is going to be for the Future Saga category. Future Saga category best links are going to be, well, Trunks, pretty much. His best links, five or more, is going to be all the Trunks. We pretty much discussed all of them already. Let me go translate that to English real quick. So it's what, 10 key, 25% and 4 key with that Trunks. This one is going to be 4 key, 25%. This Trunks is going to be 25 and 4 key. And this Trunks is probably going to be 25 and 4 key. Yep. So all these guys pretty much have the same exact effect. This one has immense damage. Probably is going to be the most damage dealing. This one is free to play. And this Trunks is not free to play, but you could easily get him up to super attack 10. Definitely freely grind getting up to super attack 10 a lot easier than this Trunks. So again, play to your strengths. Play to who you're going up against if you plan on doing that. Now I'm going to go ahead and save the actual future category saga team building to the end of the video. So if you want to jump about another 10 minutes, you can go, or 8 minutes, you can go ahead and do that to the end of the video. That's where I'm going to discuss the actual future team building guide. And we'll discuss that there. So another ending Super Saiyan Trunks future saga category key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 70%. Now obviously you're going to want to run the Gohan if you have him over this Trunks, but if you don't and you want to run a future category team, you're going to want to get him because he is technically free to play. If you didn't do the grind, which I know it is a pain in the butt to do this freaking grind, prime battles always suck, but you can do this and you can get this future category saga free leader. He does do 2 super attacks, burning attack, and change the future 12 to 17 key and 18 key respectively. The burning attack does colossal damage to the enemy. Change the future greatly raises attack for one turn, causes mega colossal damage to the enemy. Passive skill, true ending, attack plus 25,000 at the start of the turn. Key plus 8 and attack and defense plus 20,000 when facing two or more enemies. So this kind of like is never going to happen because you're pretty much going to be running on Dokkan events, and very few Dokkan events you're going to go and have two people on there at the same time. Usually when you do, it's the beginning of a Dokkan event and it's very easy. You just bring an AoE and wipe them all out. So honestly, he's only going to be getting a 25,000 attack buff. I personally don't think he's a great unit myself, but he's free to play unit, so you really can't do anything about that. I know he does do some decent damage when he gets his 18 plus key, especially when you make it all up to 24. Link skills are Messenger from the Future, Super Saiyan, Cold Judgment, Royal Lineage, Dismal Future, Shattering the Limit, and Legendary Power. Max stats are HP of 13,425, attack of 14,330, and defense of 10,375. Go ahead, pause the screen if you want to look at the other stats. So let's go into team building and best linking buddies. So in terms of best linking buddies, this Trunks links best with his LR counterpart, the Adolescence Trunks, not the Future Trunks. They actually can be run on the same team because this one's Adolescence or Teen Trunks. The other one is Future Trunks. They link 10% attack buff, 20% defense buff, 3 key and 5,000 attack buff, flat out boost from Legendary Power when they're doing super attacks. They do have LR Majin Vegeta, which pretty much has the same thing. It's 3 key, except they don't have Cold Judgment, so there's no defensive buff, but it's 3 key, 10% attack buff, and 5,000 attack buff. You also have the TUR variant of Trunks' LR form, which pretty much just drops Legendary Power, so he does have all the other stuff, minus the 5,000 attack buff. And then the Technique Trunks, which isn't horrible. You have Super Attack, Cold Judgment, so 10% attack buff, 20% defensive buff, and 3 key. He's not that bad. This is the GT Trunks, by the way. He is a support unit for Technique and Strength, so you're probably never going to run him on the team because he's only there to support Technique and Strength types, and he's obviously an Agility type. But if you're looking for linking buddy because you don't have anyone else because you just started, you can run him. You also have the OG crappy-ass Trunks over here, which is, let's see, what is he? Messenger from the Future, 500 flat-out boost, which sucks. Super Saiyan, common. King Bloodline, 1 key, meh. And Shattering the Limit, so 3 key, 10% attack buff. You can get it from other better units, unless you don't have any, obviously. And the other Xeno Trunks, and this one is Messenger from the Future, Cold Judgment, so 20% defense buff and 3 key, no attack buffs there. So obviously, you're going to want to run him alongside any of these guys. Unfortunately, these three up here, the best ones you're going to want to run them with are summonable LRs, and it's very difficult for anyone to get them unless you specifically rerolled or got really lucky or wailed the hell out. This Trunks over here is probably going to be another good bet for you, but again, he is a support unit for a different type than this agility, so you can't really do anything with him either. So honestly, for best linking buddies in game, it kind of sucks for him. So for mono agility, he only has three or more. That's who he links with. You do have this OG Xeno Trunks over here, and he is what? Attack plus 80%, key plus 2, attack plus 80%. Not horrible. Three link skills, which is not bad. What is it? I think it's 20. So 10% attack buff, 20% defense buff, and 2 key. Not horrible for a mono agility team. If you want to run him on a mono agility team, you also have this Vegeta over here, and he is when HP is under 80% attack and defense plus 90% up. I'm not a big fan of that. But he does have three link skills, and those link skills are Super Saiyan, so 10% and 3 key. It's up to you on which one you want to run. I would probably run this Trunks over here because you get the nice defensive buff, but it's only 2 key, so you still got to get a lot of key when it comes to him. And plus, remember, he is an LR, so you definitely want that 18 plus to go off. But that's who he has for our linking buddies for a mono agility team. For a hybrid Saiyan team, I'm pretty sure this is a hybrid Saiyan team. Four or more link skills. We already talked about the LR Trunks and this Trunks over here and the TUR variant, so we don't even talk about that. Actually, his best linking buddies are all the ones we talked about for hybrid Saiyans. All of his best linking buddies are hybrid Saiyans. We're just going to skip over hybrid Saiyans because we already talked about that for best linking buddies in game. In terms of future saga category, it's actually the same damn thing. So this guy's really running low on who he can link with. You need very, very specific units to link very well with him. If you don't have him, you're not going to be able to. And again, best one in game right now is the LR Trunks. He's part of the future category, and he's part of the hybrid Saiyan. So that's who you have available. The next one is going to be the team building guide. So I have a team building guide of everyone you could link with, and then a team that I would probably run. So this is what I'm going to say for best linking buddies in game for a future category. Now, this is specific to both the Gohan and the Trunks. So if you want to know who to run, this is the team that you could do this with. Again, LR Trunks with LR Future Trunks or LR Teen Trunks. Both of them link for 5 link skills. They definitely help each other out, get some nice buffs. You get 3 key, attack buff, a defense buff, and a flat out 5,000 boost, which is not bad at all. For future category, you also have LR Zamasu and Rose with the Zamasu and Goku Black for 6 links. Obviously, again, summonable LRs, they are there, they are available if you have them, if you're lucky enough to have them. If you don't, then, you know, you could obviously forget it. You could also run the Rose with someone else, anyone else from the Future Saga category, like the Merged Zamasu. The next one is going to be the older characters, the 100% leader and the OG 70% leader Trunks with the Vegeta. They link for 4 link skills on this team, and that's what, 25% attack buff and 3 key, which is not bad. Then primary, who I would probably always run, is the Rose and the Merged Zamasu, 5 link skills. They share big bad bosses, 1 key, 2, so 3 key, 25% attack buff when HP, or attack and defense buff when HP drops below 80%, so that's 25% attack and defense when HP drops below 80, 3 key total, and 25% attack buff all the time between Fierce Battle and Nightmare. And then you also have the options, if you have them, the TUR variants of the Supers, or the 17 and the 18 Future Saga ones. Now again, I'm probably going to be doing a team building guide with these guys, or at least go over them and talk about best linking buddies in game. I'm pretty sure these two link with each other the best. They share 3 link skills, or 6 link skills total. Cruelty for 10% attack buff. Actually, let me just say, it's what, 25% attack buff, 2, 4, 5 key, and 1,000 defense buff. A flat boost of 1,000 defense. Outside of that, you also have the Gohan over here, which he does link with some people very well. Specifically, his best one he links with, as we discussed before, is the OG Trunks. You also can run any of these two Vegitos on the team if you want. And honestly, support unit, this Trunks over here, which we have already discussed, you definitely want him on your team, because he is a pretty good support unit. All allies are attack and defense. The attack and defense of all allies go up by 25%. So he's really good, and you're definitely going to want to run him on your team. In terms of the team that I would run, this LR Trunks, I just kind of threw him in here in case you were going to run him. You could do the Gohan, because Gohan's most likely going to be on the team with you, because even if you don't have him, you're going to bring a friend with you, because you're going to want to have that friend buff instead of having a double LR Trunks lead. I mean, you can do the LR Trunks lead if you want to do a double. You can just mix and match the two of them. I'm not going to really run either of these two on primary rotation unless I could help it, you know what I mean? But this is what I would probably do. I would probably have the Rose and the Merged Zamasu running together. They do a lot of damage. They are really awesome. They buff each other very well. And Rose's passive skill for key plus 3 and defense plus 50% up for allies is phenomenal. And it's an enemy super attack. If it's super enemy, gets attack and defense minus 20%. So, I mean, like, he's just an awesome unit overall. Definitely want to have the support unit over here. This Vegito Blue, I prefer him over the Technique one just because he counters. So, I want him on my team. He may not do as much damage output total, but he does damage reduction and he has counters, which, if set up right, he can do more damage. Up to you on how you want to run it. You do have the Future Saga, so you're gonna have either two of them on rotation. You have a filling unit. I literally left it open because you can put anyone you really want here. There's really no other good support units because they don't do mono types. Like, no one does, like, the Gohan doesn't do physical buffs, and the Trunks doesn't do agility buffs. So you could throw whatever Future Saga category you want in here for an additional one. But this is pretty much the team I'm going to recommend to you that I would probably run as my favorite team. But yeah, guys, that is it. Let me know what you guys are thinking about with these Future Saga category team. If there's anything else that I missed, what else would you guys run? Which ones are you running, and which ones are you having the most fun running? But anyway, guys, that's it. Thank you for joining me here today, and I'll catch you all later. Peace out.